Did we discuss about smart search? I think we didn't discuss smart search. Okay. Let's see what is a smart search. Okay, let me go to the smart search. Okay, first of all, what is a smart search? We will discuss. So this is my Google page. And I am writing selenium. How many keywords here we are displaying? There are almost 10 set of keywords. It is suggesting related keywords. So you have to click one of the keyword. Okay, either selenium HQ or selenium download or anything. Okay, so when you are typing, some of the applications automatically some keywords will be suggested, and you have to click one of the keyword. So how to perform this action? Okay, now let's see. Because this is not a drop down, based on the keyword that value will come dynamically. So how to handle this situation? Now let's see. So I navigated to my google.co.in page. Under for that input text box, I have taken XPath, Google input text box, and in the advanced XPath, okay, in the we are having one topic, advanced XPaths here. Okay, where is that? In lab number 10, we are having one advanced XPath concept is there. I'm using that technique by you writing advanced XPath XPath. Okay, this is the advanced XPath technique, starts with. So whatever keywords will start with selenium, I want to know how many number of keywords are there in the current web page. If I want to know, so first of all, I have to write what are the keywords it is displaying. Okay, so I have written this XPath like that. Okay, just I will show you here. Just I'm copying this XPath. Control C. So first of all, I need to write selenium. So here, if you see all letters which was started small s, so that's why I'm taking starts with the text also small s only. Okay, just a minute, I will show you.
These capitals.
All other letters are in small here keywords. Okay, so Control F, Control V. See all the list of keywords which are displayed started with small s only. So just I'm searching 1 of 10, it is showing 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 like this. Okay, so now we understood. So suppose if you want to click some smart search, if it is coming, we need to take starts with the text of whichever key you are looking for, whatever is list of keywords is displayed, just because all other keywords information is changing, so the whichever text is fixed, that line I am giving in my XPath. Okay, so like this XPath has been written. After that, what is the points we need to discuss? Okay, just a minute. Right, now let's go to here. So now we understood how the this XPath has been written. So I'm typing selenium and I'm clicking on send key. So I'm typing as selenium and I'm clicking send keys, and after that automatically list of keywords are displaying. So when I'm typing here, when I'm typing selenium, automatically those list of keywords are coming. Now I want to click one of the keyword. So here I'm getting multiple number of keywords. So if it is more than one key, web elements are displaying, so then we have to write driver dot find elements. It's not a single web element, that's why I'm writing driver dot find elements by XPath. What is the XPath to capture all the web elements? So this is the same XPath I have given. So all the list of web elements will be stored in this rows. So whatever, so those 10 keywords will be stored in this web element object. Okay, and if I want to know how many number of keywords, just I'm printing like this. So I will come to know how many number of words is there in that web page. So like that I understood, fine. Now Now I want to select one of the, I want to click one of the keyword. Okay, what I need to do? Okay, so as of now I have taken same thing. Okay, so if you'll come to here, I will going to tell you one more advanced XPath technique here. Just see this one. So one second. So if you go to here, so I have taken this one. This is advanced XPath technique. How many web elements are following the tag as span? Okay, so span of one I am writing. So span of one means this is selecting. Span of two means how many web elements are following with span tag in the HTML page. So if I will inspect this one automatically, this is the web element it is selected, and which means this is the span tag. So the complete text is under span tag. So how many web elements for this are following with the tag name as span? I am checking. So following span, so how many are there? So just if I don't write anything, all the 1 of 23 it is showing. So I am writing as of 1, so it's selecting, and as of 2 it is selecting, and if I am selecting 3 it is selecting. So which means if I will write a for loop and if I will change this 4 value, automatically I can able to select the particular web element. So that's why how I have written this XPath. This is the XPath. Okay, just if that scenario will come, just I'm telling one example. Okay, so following span of 4, so here 4 means the str of I am writing. So this value I'm concatenating with this string, and like this we need to write. This is the expression format I need to write. So just I have taken. So if you will get the any same scenarios, just you can refer this program, you can understand how to write the expression format. So after that I'm printing my, so that particular XPath I'm finding that web element, and this str1 I am e-drive, my element web driver is identifying, and that particular web element I'm selecting. So element dot location once scrolled into view, so whichever web element is selected, automatically my scrolling will be done just like this. Just one part will be scrolling. After that, web element text is equal to web element text is equal to whatever that element text contains. I want to get that text, and I am printing here web element dot text. So after that, I am printing. So like this, I am printing each and every web element information. What is the element text, and I am repeating my for loop. Okay, how many number of similar web elements are there on that smart search. Okay, so here I am able to get that value. Okay, that's it on the complete explanation part. Now let's run this program and we will see. So here the program is completely related to logical point. Okay, this scenario nobody will ask in the interview, just I am telling from project purpose, that's it only. See, after every 5 seconds I am selecting appropriate web element. So once it is select, so how to click, I want to click on Selenium HQ, so how to click that one also we will see right now. So like this, each and every web element text is highlighted, and whatever text I have selected, okay, so whatever text I have selected, here it is printing. Web element text is Selenium HQ, web element text is Selenium tutorial, web element text is Selenium web driver. So which means, so here in my program, element dot text, I'm getting the text whichever web element, I'm printing that web element information. Suppose if my web element text is, okay, how to write if conditions, we have seen here. Just a minute, I will copy here. So not this one, not this one, browsers compatibility testing. Okay, Right. So I'm going to write one more condition here. If web element text is this one, if web element text is okay, Selenium HQ. Where is this? Selenium HQ. Okay. I want to do element dot click. I want to perform element dot click. Element dot click. Okay, if web element text is okay, just I'm writing up to here only. So we need to write like this. Okay, right. So I have written like this. And if web element text is Selenium HQ, I want to click on the Selenium HQ, and after that I want to exit from for loop. Okay, so break statement. Yes, so I want to break completely from the for loop. Okay, so I have written, so if whenever I will click, so the rest of the iterations it won't be proceeded. So whenever that line will come, so a break means it will execute totally from the for loop, completely exited from the for loop. Rest of the iterations it won't be proceeded at all. Okay, so now let's run this program this time. See, like that, it's navigated to Selenium HQ page. It's clicked. Now let's go to here. Okay, web element text is Selenium HQ, and the rest of the for loop it's not continued. Totally, it is exited, and finally it's passed. So.